So effectively, the planet is fucked.
No, I don't know about that. But this coronavirus thing, pretty scary, right?
I am not sure how to deal with it. I haven't seen Ben all day. I'm not quite sure where he is. However, I did wake up at like 2 p.m., so I'm sure he's all right. I've been doing research on how the coronavirus spreads, the symptoms, its weaknesses, and I think I've assembled a list on possible tactics, on ways to immunize myself. Step one, preparation. I've been doing some research, and it seems like the best way to prevent the virus is to prepare for it.
Hey, the boys back home used to make fun of me, calling me the harmonica, because this made a really annoying noise. All I have to say now is, who's laughing now, boys? I also found out that apparently your phone is one of the most germ-infested things that you own, but I'll just download an antivirus on there and I'll be good to go.
Those damn crows outside my room. That is a sign of the pestilence. Get out of here!
Update. I'm good now. He left.
Motherfucker!
Okay, once you've disinfected everything, step two is escape. You have to find a way to get out of here if the disease starts spreading further. So grab your passport and hightail it to Canada. Wait, what's that? Oh, okay. Never mind, Canada is way too far and way too expensive. Let's go to LA. Okay, so since LAX is the friggin' hotbed of the disease, I'm not taking a plane. And I don't have a car, so... train it is then. But then I realized that frickin' tickets to LA were highway robbery, so what else do I have that has wheels? We walking, boys. All right, step three is survival. If all else fails and you're stuck here, you gotta find a way to make do with what you got. First things first, you need a weapon to defend yourself with.
All right, so the way we're gonna make this deadly weapon is you need a fork, you need a piece of wood, or just any kind of stick, and some tape.
Some of y'all may be asking, Luke, why don't you just use a knife instead of a fork? That's way sharper. Well, my dang roommates haven't washed their dishes this week, and all of the knives are dirty in the sink. We might be in the apocalypse, but we're not animals. On the other hand, they might all be dead by now, so...
And there you go. I call it fork on a stick. Look at the amount of range I have. Normally, you know, my arms can reach only about here. But with this fork on a stick, I can reach all the way off camera. You don't know what I'm hitting over here. Take that, zombie. Bah, 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 bah.
Second method to survive is finding food. All the grocery stores and fast food joints are gonna close down. You're gonna have to hunt on your own. Here's how I did it.
While I was outside looking for some food, I came across some prey. It was perfect, a wild can of Chef Boyardee ravioli. I quickly jumped on it and captured it and brought it back for consumption.
All right,
I managed to capture this wild can of Chef Boyardee ravioli. Very excited about this. You know, it may seem inhumane for some people to like just take a wild, innocent can of Chef Boyardee out in the wild, but it's the dang apocalypse. I gotta do what I can. Fork on a stick is really coming in handy here. Wouldn't be able to do that with a knife.
All right, so after that delicious meal, we only have one step left. We need to go buy one of those pollution masks that they sell at the local pharmacy. But it's a few miles away, and we're running out of daylight. So let's go.
All right, Christian and I are going to the store to get plague masks. We have to make it there before sunset, or otherwise the infected are going to get us.
Into the breach.
All right.
Where are you feeling?
Where are we headed?
Making a vlog.
More or less.
Well, we're going to Walgreens to get Luke a mask because he's paranoid, and I'm getting a passport.
Hey, paranoid. Have you seen Ben today?
No.
Yeah.
What about him?
Yeah. I mean, I haven't seen him either. Just saying. We're here now. It's time.
Super excited.
Oh my gosh. Wait, Ashley, where are they?
Excuse me, yes. Could you point me in the direction of like the pollution masks?
We don't have any at the moment.
No, are you all out?
Yep.
Dang. Mm-hmm.
Sorry about that.
They're all out.
Not really?
They're all sold out, dude. Gotta go somewhere else.
This is tragic. This is the absolute worst song to be playing right now.
So, they're also out at CVS. We have no options left.
This is a sad moment. We're out of options. I've done all I can, but it's a respiratory virus. I need protection for my respiratory system. So, things ain't looking good.
Time to get some grub. Now we go back to the room with heavy hearts.
This is all your fault, you son of a bitch. You know what? I'm going out on my own terms. If you're the thing that started it, I'm gonna be the one to end it.
Well, guys, it's official. There's nothing we can do to stop the coronavirus. It's probably already in my system. It's only a matter of hours. Well, I guess there's nothing else to do than just text my loved ones and let them know that I love them. I'm gonna miss them. Gotta start writing my will. Gotta get Mikey to delete all of the Chinese dungeon porn off my laptop.
What's up?
Hey, are you talking about this coronavirus?
Yeah, dude, it's too late for me. What are you talking about? No, it's like, it's a pandemic. Like, it's all over the globe.
The only case in California has been quarantined. You're
what?
Fine.
What? What? I'm fine?
You're an idiot.
No way! Let's go! Let's go, baby!
Dude, have you heard? The first case of the coronavirus in Canada is right around where we live. What? That's okay. We're more of a Stella man anyway.